Amen. Back on door, we thank God for Red. Amen. Very studious young man. Amen. Very studious and gifted. Amen. Continue to pray for him. Amen. Matthew the 12th chapter, you may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Matthew the 12th chapter. Matthew the 12th chapter. Hallelujah. Matthew the 12th chapter. Verse 9 through 10 to 13 and 14 will be the four key scriptures that I'll deal with in that text. Matthew the 12th chapter. Thank you, Jesus. Verse 9 through 10 and 13 and 14. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. When you have it, could you please say amen? Matthew the 12th chapter, verse 9 and 10. And when he was departed thence, he went into the synagogue. And behold, there was a man which had his hand withered. And they asked him, saying, is it lawful to heal on the Sabbath days that they might accuse him? Look at verse 13 and 14. Then said he to the man, stretch forth your hand. Mm-hmm. And he stretched it forth, and it was restored like as of the other hand.
Yes.
Then the Pharisees went out and held a council against him, how they might destroy him. Mm-hmm. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Stretch out.
Stretch out
what you have left.
What you have left.
And stretch out.
And stretch out
what you have.
And what you have.
Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Stretch out.
Stretch out
what you have left.
What you have left.
And stretch out.
And stretch out
what you have.
And what you have.
One time, say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Stretch out.
Stretch out
what you have left.
What you have left.
And stretch out.
And stretch out
what you have.
And what you have.
Amen. Saints of God, a lot of times when we want God to do the miraculous and we want more from God, sometimes, saints of God, you have to go beyond where you're at right now. You have to get ready to stretch out.
Yes.
We heard the woman of God this morning speaking about God stretches out.
Stretch.
See, saints of God, God wants you to stretch so God can do more for you.
Yes.
When we want miracles in our lives, sometimes you have to go just a little bit farther.
Yes.
Sometimes when you want a financial blessing from God, sometimes you have to stretch out and give just a little bit more.
Yes.
I know, saints of God, that we don't want to hear it like that, but this is the way that God operates when we stretch ourselves.
Yes.
When we stretch ourselves before God. Saints of God, you got to stretch yourself in prayer. This is the time when you begin to stretch yourself in prayer just a little bit more.
Yes.
You need to give God just a little bit more time. This is a time when you stretch yourself, when you begin to study the word of God, and you begin to give God just a little bit more time. This is a time, saints of God, when you stretch yourself in your love walk. Because, saints of God, you're going to meet some people that you're going to really have to stretch in order to love them.
Yes.
But, saints of God, you got to get to that place in God where you will stretch.
Yes.
God want to do more in your life, but you got to be willing just to go a little bit farther. You got to come outside of your comfort zone, saints of God, because some of us have got comfortable in the place that we're at. But saints of God, you got to get ready to come outside your comfort zone.
Yes.
You got to get ready to stretch yourself in God. God want to take you somewhere. God want to take you higher. God want to take you to another dimension. God want to take you to another level.
Yes.
But you got to get ready to stretch yourself.
Yes.
Saints of God, we have to be stretchable in order for God to use us. We can't be like no brittle pan, saints of God, when we're not stretchable. But you got to be stretchable. When God says give a little bit more, sometimes you got to give a little bit more. When God says stay in prayer just a little bit longer, you got to stay down in prayer just a little bit longer. Saints of God, I told you this morning that we need to be able to wait on God. Saints of God, you got to stretch yourself and wait on God. Because sometimes we get impatient with God, and sometimes, God, you taking too long. And God, it's been 30 minutes, God, and you ain't did nothing yet. But let me tell you something. Sometimes you got to be still and know that God is God. Sometimes, saints of God, you got to stretch yourself. You got to stretch yourself in the presence of God, because God, I want more of you. I want to stretch myself in the presence of God, because God, I want to walk in your anointing, oh God. I want to walk in your power. I want to walk in your glory, oh God. You got to stretch yourself. Come on, look at your name and say, get ready to stretch yourself. Get ready to stretch yourself in the name of God. To stretch yourself to go higher in God. You're ready to stretch yourself to go to another dimension in God. All you got to ready to stretch yourself, saints of God. All you got to push your playback, saints of God, and say, God, I'm asking you to stretch me, oh God. Stretch out my belly for more of you, oh God. Stretch me, oh God. Stretch you and put a yes down inside my belly, oh God. Turn this situation around, oh God. I need you to restore me. I need to be stretched. I need you to revive me, oh God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. God asks you to stretch me.
Stretch me, oh God.
God, I want you to stretch yourself.
Yes,
You got to do just a little bit more. Do you hear me say, God? It does not mean that God don't see what you've been doing. But God has said, I want you to give just a little bit more. Yes, do just a little bit more. Because God is trying to stretch you. Says God is not going to feel comfortable when God is stretching you. It's not going to feel right when God is stretching you. Call Naaman to the stand. Oh, yeah. The Bible said Naaman was a man, he was a leper.
Yes.
But at the same time, he was a general over the army.
Uh-huh.
This man had some rank, but the man had leprosy all in his skin.
Yep,
the Bible said he went down to Israel to the prophet Elisha. That's the first thing you're going to have to do. You have to stretch yourself and step outside your pride and get down to the house of God.
Yes.
But the Bible said he went down to the prophet. And the prophet told him, go to the Jordan and dip seven times.
Dip seven times.
God said, when you dip seven times, God said, you're going to come back healed.
Yes.
Now, since God, I told you that this man was a general.
Uh-huh.
This man had some rank.
Yeah.
This man said, that looked foolish for me to go down into the muddy waters of the Jordan and dip myself seven times.
Yeah.
He said, I'm not finna do that. And he began to walk away. But the people that was with him, they said, Father, if the prophet would have told you to do something great, wouldn't you did it?
Yeah.
And the Bible said he turned around and went back to the Jordan and went down and dipped seven times. Do you hear me?
Yeah.
Sometimes you got to stretch yourself. It might look stupid what God is telling you to do, but let me tell you something, you got to stretch yourself. Some people, God will heal them if they just learn how to stretch themselves. You got to step outside of your comfort zone and get ready to say to God, let's stretch yourself.
My God.
Call the woman, oh my God, with the little oil and little meal.
Uh-huh.
Gave it to the prophet first. But she was stretching what she had.
Yes.
And when she gave to the prophet, the Bible said that her and her family ate for many days.
Hey!
Because she stretched what she had that was in her hand. Do you hear me say, God, call the little boy with the two fish and five loaves of bread.
Come on.
That's all he had, but he gave it to Jesus.
Yep.
Do you hear me say, God? So you got to be willing to give what you have over to Jesus if you want God to stretch you.
Yes.
And this is the reason why I told you, stretch what you have well. Because some of us say, this is all I got left. But what you got left, give it unto God and let God stretch it into something big. You can hear me say, God, you got to get ready to stretch.
Yes.
The one with issue of blood.
Yes.
Woman believed for 12 whole years.
My God.
Didn't know what to do. Spent all her money on doctors.
Mm-hmm.
Got worse. Oh my God. She was considered unclean. But she got up one morning and said, this morning, I got to stretch.
Yeah.
Do you hear me say, God? Yeah. I got to stretch and press my way through the crowd. Do you hear me say, God? And when she stretched, she drew back power and she got healed.
Yeah.
So somebody, you got to get ready to stretch yourself.
Yeah.
You got to go beyond where you're at right now and stretch yourself.
Yeah.
And say, I need more of God. Do you hear me say, God? I need to be healed.
Yeah.
I need to be delivered. I need to be set free. I need God to turn the situation around. Save my children. I need God to deliver my mind. I need God to deliver my emotions. This is not the time for you to sit there and look all cute. You gotta stretch yourself.
Hey, yes.
Oh, yeah. You gotta stretch yourself up. You gotta press your way.
Hey.
Like the mama, it's your blood. You gotta be just like Zacchaeus and go up a tree and see Jesus passing by. You hear me say, stop. You gotta stretch.
Stretch.
Oh,
my God.
Oh, my God.
My God.
And we're dealing with a man hearing this text. Who stretched out?
Yes.
When Jesus told him to stretch out. Say, yes. God, I told you, you got to go past your comfort zone.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Some of us don't want to go past our comfort zone.
Come on.
Okay, God, I gave that. But God said, give a little bit more.
Yes, Lord.
Even times me and my wife, it was our last penny. And God said, give all of it. Give all of it. See, you got to know how to stretch.
Yes.
When we obey God, we reap the blessing every time.
Yes.
Do you hear me saying to God? Because we've learned over the years that sometimes you got to step outside your comfort zone and sometimes you got to stretch.
Yes. Oh, my God.
This man here in this text in Matthew chapter 12.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, my God, was a man with a withered hand.
Yes.
His hand was pulled back.
Mm-hmm.
And look at verse 9, because I want to talk to some of us now.
Yes, Lord.
And I want to speak to some of those on YouTube. Yes, Lord, with your disobedient self.
My God.
Look at verse 9. And when he was departed from this, he went where?
Into the synagogue.
He went into the synagogue. The Bible said Jesus' custom was that he always went into the synagogue.
Yes.
Some of us say to God, we want God to do something great for us, but we never come into his house.
Come on.
Back then, the synagogue was a place of worship.
Uh-huh.
It was a place of praise. It was a place where you went and heard the word of God. The synagogue was just like the house of God right now.
Yeah.
But since God, sometimes we want to get out of that bed, we don't want to come into the house of God. But yeah, we want God to heal us. We want God to deliver us. We want God to set us free. And I'm too tired. And I feel pain in my body. Well, you didn't feel that way when you went to work. You still went to work, but when it comes out to the house of God, you can't come into the house of God. You didn't feel that way when you went over your boo's house. Come on now, say to God. But when it comes out to the house of God, I can't get up and I cannot go into the house of God. But the Bible said Jesus' custom was that he always went into the house of God.
Yeah.
A lot of us say we want to be like Jesus, but we never get up and come into the house of God.
Yeah.
If you want to be like Jesus, you're going to get up, you're going to come into the house of God. The Bible said that when Jesus was 20 years old, his family went up to the feast, and they lost Jesus. He went back to the temple. They came back looking for him. He was in the temple, 12 years old, asking the grown men questions about the word of God. The Bible said that the grown men was kind of perplexed because they said, how can these young men got this kind of wisdom?
Yeah.
But when his mother found him, she said, why did you treat us like this? She said, we lost you. And Jesus told him, he said, why are you seeking me? He said, do you not know I must be about my father's business and I must be in my father's house? Be here and sense God. You got to learn to get down to the synagogue.
Yeah.
You got to learn to get down to the house of God.
Yeah.
When you come into the house of God, there is a balm inside of Gideon.
Yeah.
There is healing inside of the house of God.
Hallelujah.
There is breakthrough in the house of God.
Yes.
There is turnaround in the house of God.
Yes.
There is restoration in the house of God.
Yes.
There is revival in the house of God.
Yes.
The glory of God awaits you. The word of God awaits you. You got to get down inside of the house of God.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Yes, Lord.
Jesus.
My God.
Was his custom.
Oh, God.
To go into the house of God. The Bible said, forsake not the assembling of yourselves together, which is the manner of some. The Bible says some people have stopped coming together. Some people have stopped coming into the house of God. We got people telling ourselves, I don't got to go to church to be saved. No, you don't have to go to church to become saved, but you got to come to church to stay saved. You hear me say to God? Because a lot of people stand back at home and they know God is telling them, we're coming to the house of God. Guess what? You ain't going to get delivered. You ain't going to get set free. God ain't going to turn that situation around. You disobeying God. You out of order. Do you hear me say to God? You got to press your way into the house of God.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
I love God. No, you don't. You don't even come in God's house.
My God.
This is your father's house.
Right.
How do you love God and you don't come into God's house?
God.
Come on, saints of God. We stay at home and look at football. We stay at home and look at basketball. We care about sports more than we care about God.
Come
and
on.
Then we get an attitude when the pastor tells us you need to be in the house of God.
Yes.
The Bible said, forsake not.
Forsake
not. The assembling of yourselves together, which is the matter of some. How come the early church came together, but we don't?
Yes, Lord.
The modern day church said, we don't have to come to church to be saved. Guess what? You would die and go to hell.
Yes,
you know why? Because number one, you disobeyed God.
Yes,
you already told God, I'm not finna do what your word say. And I'm not finna go into your house. But let me tell you something. Let's come. Some people are in darkness right now. All the devil boxing their head.
Oh,
the devil tearing you up. All in your spirit. You feel depressed. You're down in darkness. You're back on drugs. Do you hear me say to God? Are you down in a dark place? You can freeze inside your mind. Because why? I don't have to go into the house of God.
My God.
But his custom was to go into the synagogue. Because it's in a synagogue where you get delivered. Go down to the courthouse. And watch they give you a fine and give you some time. Go down to the strip club. And watch they just shake their butt in your face. Do you hear me say, God? Go down to the gambling house. And they gonna take all your money. Go to the liquor store. And the man gonna take your money at the window. Do you hear me say, God? But all when you coming to God's house, you got to know where to go to, say, God. All you going to booze house, and booze can't help you. Do you hear me say, God? You gotta come into the house of El Shaddai. You gotta come into the house of Jehovah Nissi.
Yes.
And Jehovah Shalom and Jehovah Tissi. You gotta come into the house of God.
Hallelujah.
My life changed when I kept coming to the house of God.
Yes,
the pastor had to get up and preach and tell me, you need to be in the house of God.
Hey.
Because the Bible said that Jesus' sheep know his voice.
Know
and
his
a stranger,
voice.
They were not following. Listen, they don't have to tell me. I got up and came into the house of God.
Yes,
let me tell you something. The background that I came from, the darkness that I came from, I needed to be in the house of God.
Yeah.
I can't be over at the club and be over the elevation. I got to get into the house of God.
Yeah.
I need to be delivered. I need to be set free. I need to be revived. I need to be restored.
Yeah.
I need to be corrected. Did you hear me say, God? You got to make your way down to the house of God.
Yes, Lord. Thank you.
He went into the synagogue.
Yes, Lord.
And when he got inside the church, look at verse 10. Behold, there was a man which had his hand withered.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible didn't give this man a name. It didn't give his educational background. It didn't say what race he was.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't say who his family was. The Bible just said a man. Had a withered hand.
Yeah, yes,
because disease don't discriminate.
Uh-huh.
People are the only ones that discriminate.
Yes.
Disease and death don't discriminate. Sorrow and depression and fear don't discriminate.
Yes.
It's only when you come to mankind that we want to put people in a certain class. But God don't put people in a certain class.
Yes.
You can call out to God and don't nobody got to know your name. You can call out to God and you don't have to have no PhD. You even say, nobody got to know you. You don't have to be riding on rims. You don't have to be standing on benches. Only thing you got to do is say, Jesus. For whoso will call on the name of the Lord shall be saved, shall be delivered, shall be set free. You hear me say, God, you have to know how to call out to Jesus. A certain man.
A certain
man. Had his hand withered.
Yeah.
When you read Luke's account, he said it was his right hand.
Uh-huh.
When you looked at the man, his hand was drawn up like this.
Uh-huh.
One hand was whole and the other hand was withered.
Yeah.
Withered. The hand represents power.
Uh-huh.
It represents authority. You use the hand to grip stuff.
Hey.
Well, this man didn't have no power because his hand was withered up.
Yeah.
This is a person who don't got no power to break out because their power is drawn back.
Jesus.
We heard the word of God say this morning is that you got to get to the king and touch his scepter, which means his authority and his power.
Yeah.
You get that through intercessory prayer. You hear me say, God, but this man didn't have no power because his hand was shrunk. This man didn't have no authority. The hand is where you grip stuff.
Yeah. Yes, Lord.
That's how you know when your hand withered, when you can't grab something that God told you to grab and hold on to it.
Yeah.
You grab onto God, but then you let God go.
Yes.
Because you don't got no power in your hand. Yes. You hear me say, God, the hand represent, you can show people affection with the hand.
Uh-huh.
I want to talk to some of us now.
Yes,
because it took me a while to reach out to my own wife with my hands.
My God.
You say, what do you mean by that? Because some of us have been so hurt and abused and rejected that it's hard for us to show affection to anybody.
Yes.
You can't even reach out with your hand.
Yes.
See, just because you're having sex with somebody don't mean that you're reaching out really in affection. You hear me say, God, you can't even go up and get nobody a hug. You got just that much hurt inside of you.
My God.
The Bible says his hand was withered, which means it was drawn back. This is when a person draw back. Their hands are drawn back.
Yes.
I ain't finna love nobody no more. They hurt me, and I'm not hugging nobody no more.
Yes.
The hands are used to hug.
Uh-huh.
They hurt me, I'm not helping nobody no more.
Uh-huh.
Because with the hands, you help people. Do you hear me say, God?
Yes.
I'm not helping nobody anymore. Don't come ask me for nothing. I'm not finna help anybody. Why? Now your hand has been withered. And first it was stretched out, but now you done pulled it in.
Yes.
And ain't nobody finna get no love for me. And I'm not gonna love nobody. I'm not gonna trust anybody. You got walls up around you. You know why? Because your hand is withered. Because your hand has been pulled back.
Yes.
You can't love anybody anymore, but say to God, you got to grit to stretch yourself all over again.
Yes.
You say, yeah, they hurt me. Yeah, they left me. Yeah, they abused me. Yeah, they rejected me. But I'm going to get inside of God.
Yes.
And I'm going to stretch out, and I'm going to love all over again.
Yes.
You hear me say, God? The Bible says his hand.
His hand.
Yes.
Rhythm.
Uh-huh.
Yes, Lord.
No authority and power to break out of his situation.
My God.
The Bible said his hand was paralyzed. I told you that when you deal with people being paralyzed, you deal with paralysis.
Uh-huh.
Paralysis is when the brain sends a signal through the spinal cord, through the nerves, to your hand and tell your hand to move.
Mm-hmm.
Well, when this man's brain sent the signal through his spinal cord and to his nerves and told his hand to move, his hand wouldn't move. What the head said didn't get to the hand.
Yes.
We know that Jesus is the head of the church.
Yes.
Now when he gives a word, do you hear me? You have to be able to receive that word so you can break out of
paralysis.
You hear me say,
Lord.
The Bible said he was paralyzed.
Yes,
Lord. Some of us are paralyzed because we have not received the word from the head, which is Jesus Christ, who is the head of the church. But say, God, you got to get your yourself to the position where I'm going to get myself in the position and I'm going to hear a word from the head,
yes,
which is Jesus Christ.
My God.
The Bible said, man should not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeded and go forth out of the mouth of God. All the word of God will change you.
Yes.
The word of God will deliver you.
Amen.
The word of God will direct you. Save you.
Yes.
You can God. It's the word of God with the anointing of God that destroys every yoke and lift every burden, break every chain, break every feather. You can hear me say to God.
Yes.
It's the word of God that will pull you out of darkness,
yes,
and translate you into the kingdom of light. It's,
yes,
the word.
The word. The word. Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
Spoke a word.
Spoke a word.
But the word never got to you.
Yes, Lord.
Maybe because you're so hurt that the word can never get to you.
My God.
The Bible said when Moses went to bring them people out of Egypt, and Pharaoh put more work on them, and Moses met them in a way, and Moses said, keep trusting God, wait on God. He said, God won't bring you out, and they kept walking. The Bible said they didn't listen to Moses because of the hardness of their heart and because of what they was going through. Since God, sometimes the preacher is preaching, but you can't receive it because your heart is so hurt in what you're going through right now. You in a dark place right now. You in a confused place. The man of God is speaking to you. He don't even know you. He don't even stay in your house.
Yes.
The man of God is dealing with your situation. All saints of God, you need the Lord's word. You need the rhema word.
Yes.
You need to learn about your situation.
Yes.
God asked you to bring me out, oh God. The word that changed Pastor Ellis.
Yes,
the word.
The word.
But this man had never received the message.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because the nerves was damaged.
Mm.
Because nerves take messages to your hands.
Yeah, yeah,
your,
yeah,
feet.
Yeah, yeah.
Your eyes. Do you hear me say to God? See, the reason why I'm moving my hand is because my hand got the message on your hand. And so my hand began to move. Do you hear me say to God? Which means that my nerves are not damaged. Some of us got some damaged nerves.
My God, my God.
Everything irk our nerves. It just hurt me. I can't stand nobody. I don't like nobody. And stop looking at me. Do you hear me say to God? Because your nerves have been damaged. Something happened to you. Do you hear me say to God? At a young age, that now you got your hand held back.
Yes.
I love nobody.
Yes, Lord.
Pastor, come down. How you doing? God bless you. Welcome to the United Kingdom Tag Team Ministry. You know why? Because you damaged yourself with your spirit. You hear me say, Scott, you saw never want to trust anybody.
Yes.
But you got to get ready to stretch. You got to get ready to trust somebody. You got to get ready to stretch.
Yes.
It's not going to trust God. You got to get ready to stretch. It's not going to let somebody love me.
Yes.
I'm going to let somebody care about me. I'm going to let somebody direct me.
Yes.
You hear me say, Scott,
yes,
you got to get ready to stretch.
Yes.
Look at your neighbor and say, go one more time. Was paralyzed. And Jesus came into the synagogue. This morning when God's presence showed up in here.
Yes, Lord.
Dad said he had a fever.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
But the deacon said he had a fever, but he said it left him.
Yes, Lord.
God.
Yes, Lord.
Because being in the presence of God.
Yes, Lord.
He ain't lying, because when I was sitting there, I laid hands on his head and his head was sweating.
Yes,
like somebody had just rained water on his head.
Yes,
you hear me say, God.
Yes,
but he said, while he was there, he said, now the fever left, but he feel hot on the inside. That ain't nothing but the fire of God.
Hey!
I want to put the fire of God and the fire of God. Let me tell you something. It can be 15 people, don't make no difference to me. But long as the fire of God is flowing, and the anointing of God is flowing, and the power of God is flowing, and living words is flowing, and the word of God is flowing, I'm going to get my breakthrough.
Yes.
Oh, God, when you come into the room,
hey,
everything changes.
Yes,
do you hear me say, God?
Yes,
the it starts to trickle when you come into the room. Oh, when Jesus come into the room, then it starts to trickle out. When Jesus come in the room, then it will leave outside your body. When Jesus come in the room, all the yoke is destroyed. The chain is broken. The family is broken. When Jesus comes. When Jesus come into your house,
yes,
the atmosphere will change.
Yes, Lord.
I went from coming to God almost 20 years ago.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A brother from the streets, a brother from the gutter, came to God. And my atmosphere was chaotic when I first came to God.
Yes, Lord.
It was very chaotic.
Yes, Lord.
It was smoking, it was drinking, it was kicking it. I was listening to Tupac. I want to be in NIGGA so we can get drunk and smoke weed all day. Be here and sense God. All the atmosphere was very chaotic. But when I came to Jesus, all Jesus shifted it. Be here and sense God. You need Jesus coming to your house. Shift the atmosphere. You hear me say, God, all the peace of God, and the joy of God, begin to rest in my soul. You hear me say, God, you changed my atmosphere.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
I couldn't even rest.
My God.
And I did not like peace. No, I didn't. I didn't like peace. I want to hear some noise. What you turn the radio on for? Give me him and say, God, because I couldn't rest. When I came to God, they turned the radio down. Now I'm making too much noise. Give me him and say, God, I'm enjoying my peace.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Jesus stepped into the synagogue.
Yes, Lord.
And when Jesus stepped into the synagogue, the people tried to test him. The Pharisees said, can a man be healed on the Sabbath? Because they knew Jesus was going to get ready to heal the man. They had a misunderstanding about the Sabbath, which was a day of rest. You hear me say, God? They said, you don't supposed to heal on the Sabbath day. When people got a misunderstanding in the house of God, they'll keep you bound.
Yes.
When you got people that preach the word to you and they preaching it the wrong way, guess what? It'll keep you bound.
Yes.
How you going to tell me God don't heal no more? He don't heal now in the New Testament. What are you talking about?
Yes.
God was healing in the Old Testament. You can even say, God, you mean to tell me that the Holy Ghost lived down inside that preacher and God don't heal and God don't speak and
come
God
on.
Don't deliver? Something is wrong with that. And I need to leave outside the house of God.
Come
if God
on.
Ain't speaking, if God ain't delivering, if God ain't setting come free, on. If God ain't healing, if God ain't turning people's situation around, if I'm still about to be restored with God, if I'm still about to feel the power of God, I need to leave outside the house of God.
Yes.
You gotta understand that God.
God.
He's still human.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We just heard Dad say
yes,
that God healed him.
Yes, Lord.
See, we want to look over there.
Yes.
We don't clap our hands because we don't know what to praise God. But the people just said, God healed me.
God healed
me. Say,
yes, Lord.
You can't tell the man that's been healed that God don't heal. But all we need is the power of God back into the house of
yes,
God.
Yes, Lord.
Lord.
My God.
Religious leaders
yes, Lord.
Are those who sit up with their hands folded. Looking down their glasses.
Yeah.
At you. God don't heal and God don't deliver and God don't set free. These are mean people who misunderstand the word of God.
Yes.
And they think because they older, they think you should listen to them because they older and they don't even know what they're talking about. Be here in saints of God. But saints of God, don't you let religious people tell you it's a certain day that you're supposed to be healed. Because the Bible said that Jesus told them, listen, they said, can a man be healed on a Sabbath day?
Yeah. My God.
They say, oh man, I'm supposed to be healed on a Sabbath day. What difference does it make? What day it is that a person is healed? You didn't even say, God,
yes,
don't you let people tell you, it ain't going to happen this day.
Yes.
Devil, you a liar.
You a liar.
For this is the day that the Lord has made.
Yes.
I shall rejoice in this day.
I shall rejoice.
Oh, that child ain't going to get saved today, but maybe some other day. No, devil, they're getting saved today.
Yes.
You hear me say, God?
Yes.
Oh, you ain't going to get healed today. No, devil, I'm getting healed today.
Yes.
You ain't going to break out today. No, devil, I'm breaking out today.
Yes.
You hear me say, God?
Yes.
I'm breaking out with the power of God. I'm breaking out with the thunder of God. I'm breaking out with the anointing of God. I'm breaking out with the glory of God.
Yes,
this is today.
This is today.
That the Lord has made.
Yeah.
I shall rejoice and be glad in it.
I shall.
This is the day that the Lord has made. I shall rejoice and be glad in it. You ain't caught it. I said, this is the day.
Hallelujah.
Not your problems didn't make this day.
Uh-huh.
Your enemies didn't make this day.
Come on.
What you're going through didn't make this day. But this is the day that the Lord has made.
Lord.
I'm talking about the day that El Shaddai has made.
The Lord.
That Jehovah needs him made.
The Lord.
That Jehovah Shalom has made.
The Lord.
That Jehovah Tishka has made.
The Lord.
This is the day that the Lord has made. I shall rejoice and give him praise.
Hallelujah.
I shall rejoice. descendant of Judah.
Yes, Lord.
I shall rejoice and shall bow my God.
Hey,
yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
This is the day. Yes,
this is the day.
Yes, Lord.
Get up healed.
Yeah, I'm healed.
This is the day that my past is behind me.
Yes,
yes,
Lord.
The devil said you got to wait another year before God finally forgive you. So just give it one more year and maybe God will forgive you. No, devil, this is the day. When a prodigal son made it back home, that was the day for him to be restored.
Yes.
You didn't even say to God, all the Father is waiting on you. The Father is waiting for you to come back to him. You didn't even say to God, his arms are wide open. The Sabbath was a day of rest.
The day of rest.
It was meant for man to rest from his labor and to reflect on God, the goodness of God. But the religious leader made it a bad day. Because when you deal with religious people, they make something that God created to be good, they make it bad.
Yes.
Don't want to see nobody enjoy themselves and have no fun, religious people.
My God.
Always got to find some kind of fault, religious people. You hear me say to God, this man was sitting in the synagogue and his hand was withered up.
Yes,
but
God.
Did you know none of those religious people had no power to heal him?
None.
Do you hear me say to God, something about religious people, guess what, the power of God will never be released.
Yes.
But the Bible said, they said, are you supposed to heal on the seventh day? And Jesus showed them how dumb they was. He said, which one of y'all having a sheep that fall into a pit
on the
Sabbath day? Won't you pull the sheep out the pit?
Yes.
He said, that ain't what God meant. God meant for you not to go to work on the Sabbath day. Do you hear me say, God? He said, is not a man more important than a sheep?
My God.
Do you hear me say, God? Because some people care about animals more than they care about people in trouble.
Yes.
I'm going to get in some trouble.
Yes, Lord.
But I know how to get out of here. Do you hear me say, God? You got some people. They care about their dog more than they care about people.
Oh,
you got people who care more about their cat more than they care about people. You got people that walk past a dog that's laying on the road that's hurt, and they'll check on that dog, but see a human laying there and keep right on walking. See a human says, God.
Yes,
but Jesus said, it's not a man more important than a sheep.
Yes.
Lord.
My God.
They didn't say nothing. Jesus told the man, he said, come here. On a Sabbath day.
Uh-huh.
This is your day.
Yes.
Religious leader told you it's a certain day you got to be healed.
Mm-hmm.
But Jesus said, this is your day.
This is your day.
Call the man to him.
Yes.
The first thing you got to do to be healed is that you got to come to Jesus.
You
can't keep sitting there with your hands folded. You hear me say, God?
Yes.
If the man with the withered hand would have sat there and would have got up, guess what? He would have kept that withered hand.
Yes.
And he would have left outside the house of God and still would have been paralyzed in his hand.
Yes.
And some of us coming to the house of God, we sit there, we know God talking to us, we know God moving in our heart, but we disobey God, we leave out the same way.
Yes.
The saints of God, you got to do just like the woman of God said this morning. We got to get ready to bust a move.
Yes, yes, Lord.
I got to bust a move. Do you hear me say,
yes,
God? I can't stand this darkness.
Yes.
I can't stand this confusion.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come
thank
here.
Jesus.
Yes.
The man got up with the withered hand.
With the withered hand.
Went to Jesus. And Jesus said, stretch out your hand.
Yes, Lord.
Stretch out my hand.
Yeah.
Don't you know that my hand is not receiving the signal from my brain that go down my spinal cord and travel through my damaged nerves for my hand to move? He said, I've been trying to stretch it out for years. He said, I told my brain, make my hand stretch out. He said, people got around me and said, man, just stretch your hand out. But nothing happened. But something is different here. Because Jesus told him to stretch it out.
Yes.
He didn't say, come on. All you need is a word from God. Come on, this situation. All you need is a word of God. And come on, that deliver. All you need is a word from God. Why are you coming out? Jesus told me to come out.
Yes.
You hear me say, God?
Hey.
The man that was paralyzed. Oh, my God. He was paralyzed for all them years.
Uh-huh.
When Jesus healed the man, he got up and started walking.
Hey.
Yes, Lord.
The Pharisee said, who told you to walk?
Yeah.
He said, man, ain't Jesus told me to walk. You hear me say, God? All them Jesus tell you to get up and bust a bone,
hey,
man can't stop you. You hear me say, God? I got a word from God.
Yeah. Hey!
And how he he gonna be a pastor. He's sitting up before he came to God and he's shooting people and all this kind of stuff and jumping on people and then and getting in trouble and all that. Then that boy was crazy. And how he gonna be a pastor? Because Jesus told me to be a pastor. Some of you need to get a word from God.
Yes, Lord.
And that's going to deal with that situation.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because when God say live, guess what? Can't nobody make you die.
Hey!
Yeah. He told Peter, when Jesus walked on the water, he said one word, come.
Come.
When one word, guess what? Gravity had to move out the way.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
And Peter stepped down. Oh, Lord, if you hear me say, God, we're not heard from God. You don't need nobody permission, huh? You don't need stretch needs to extend.
Yeah.
You ever got a shirt and it was too tight and you had to stretch it so they can fit, so it can be used? You had to stretch it. Do you hear me? Saints of God, in order to be used by God, you got to be stretched. Do you hear me, saints of God? It needs to extend the hand. It needs to make something go farther than what it was. When you stretch that shirt, you make that shirt longer and wider.
Yes, Lord.
This is what God said I want to do in your life.
Yes.
I want you to be stretched so I can take you higher, so I can take you a little bit longer. I want to enlarge your territory.
Yes, Lord.
Stretch out your curtains.
Yes, Lord.
Strengthen your stakes.
Come on.
Lengthen your cords.
Yes,
get ready for more.
Yes,
get ready to say, God. Get ready to go higher and go. Get ready to walk in more power.
Yes,
get ready to walk in more anointing. Get ready to walk in the glory of God. Yes, Lord. To go beyond where you're at right now.
My God, yes, Lord.
Stretch to make you more adaptable.
Stretch me, Lord.
Oh, my God.
Mm.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes,
to stretch. You know, I'm coming to a close. You know when you get ready to do some kind of sport, they'll tell you, stretch first.
Yes.
Do you hear me, saints of God?
Yes.
Stretch so that the blood can get the running through your legs. Stretch your hands so the blood can get the running through your hands.
Mm-hmm.
Why do they tell you to stretch? Because I've seen both me and my wife both have jumped up a certain way and pulled a muscle in your back.
Yes,
you know why? Because that muscle has not been stretched in a long time.
Yes.
Yes. God wants you to stretch.
Yes.
I told you in the natural you stretch before you do some activity in the natural.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
God wants you to stretch before you get ready to carry out spiritual activities for him. Do you hear me, saints of God? God wants you to get ready to stretch. Stretch in your prayer life. Stretch in your giving. Stretch in your read. Stretch in spending more time with God. Do you hear me, saints of God?
Yeah.
He said, stretch out.
Stretch out.
Mm.
Again.
Yes,
stretch out your hand.
Yes, Lord.
And his hand was restored.
Yes, Lord.
Some of you need to get ready to be restored.
Yes,
Lord. Restore means to give back what was lost.
Uh-huh.
Do you hear me, saints of God? Some of you need to be restored. It means to give back what was lost. Oh my God. Restore.
Uh-huh.
Yes, Lord.
Means to restore to his original position.
Yes,
some of you got outside position,
uh-huh,
but God said when you stretch and get back in my house,
hey,
I'm going to put you back in position. You hear me, saints of God? I'm going to take over. And you fail.
Thank you, Lord.
God said, get ready to stand back up in that position. You hear me say, God, you don't need man's position. Restore me to enjoy again. Because you get restored, you're going to enjoy the presence of God all over again. David said, God, restore to me the joy of your salvation.
Yes.
He said, God, he said, when I was happy about being saved, he said, restore to me the joy of your salvation.
Yes.
The man stretched forth his hand.
Yes, Lord.
His hand came out like the other arm.
Yes, Lord.
Both of them looking the same. Called Moses to the stand. Moses was running from the Egyptians. The Egyptians was behind them. They got to the Red Sea. Moses turned around to the people. Looked up to God and said, God, what do I do? This was a young prophet. What do I do? All these people follow me. What am I supposed to do? God said, stop crying out to me.
Yes,
God said, tell the people to keep going forward.
Yes.
God said, stretch out your hand. Yes. He never says to God.
Yes.
You have a lot of stretch out your hand.
Yes.
God says to God, let me tell you something.
Yes.
Praise will confuse the enemy.
Yes, Lord.
Yada in Hebrew means to lift the hands. It's written to God. God told Moses, if you lift your hands and stretch your hands until they surrender, guess what? I'll part the Red Sea.
Yes.
Todah means to stretch your hand, but to stretch your hands with expectation.
Yes.
You hear me say, God, when you see my hands lifted in the house of God, my hands are lifted in surrender and expectation.
Yes.
I got expectation that God is going to part my Red Sea.
Yes.
I got expectation that God will heal my body. I got expectation that God is going to turn this situation around.
Yes.
Stretch.
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 Yes,
your hands.
Lord. Yes, Lord.
You say, I don't got anything, but you got some hands.
Hey.
Lift them up and praise God.
Hey.
You hear me say, God? You got to know how to stretch.
Hey.
Moses stretched out his hand, and God parted the Red Sea.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
Joshua was going to war.
Mm-hmm.
They got whooped by Ai. They repented and got that thing right.
Yeah.
God told Joshua, he said, Joshua, stretch out your spear.
Yeah.
The spear represents war.
Yes,
says to God, some you better stretch out.
Yes,
you better get ready for war.
Yes,
you better touch God. Yes, you better pray for your family. You better plead the blood of Jesus on your family, over your mind, over your emotions. You better touch God.
Yes.
You better get ready for war. You better stretch out for war.
Stretch out. My God.
Last one. God told Peter. Peter had been fishing all night.
Yes, Lord.
Ain't caught nothing. Professional fishers.
Yes,
Jesus came down to the bank. Jesus said, let me use your boat.
Uh-huh.
He said, let me use your business.
Yes.
Peter said, go ahead. Jesus got in the boat and started preaching.
Yes.
People got to get saved. After Jesus got through preaching, he told Peter, he said, launch out into the deep.
Yes.
He said, throw your nets out there.
Yeah.
Peter said, Master, we've been fishing all night.
Yes, sir.
I'm tired. He said, we ain't caught nothing all night. But Jesus said, go out and launch out in the deep one more time.
One more time.
I want you to stretch your faith one more time.
Whatever
you got, give it over to Jesus and let God stretch it. Give it over to God. Oh, get ready to do it again. Look at your neighbor and say, get ready to do it again.
Get
ready to believe again.
Yes.
Get ready to trust God again. Get ready to step out on faith again. Get ready to walk in power again. Get ready to walk in the anointing of God again. You got to get ready to stretch things to God.
Yes,
my God.
Some of you say, I'm fighting the battle of my life right now.
Yeah.
And I'm tired.
Yes, Lord.
I just feel like giving up and throwing in the towel.
Jesus.
And you say, I don't know what to do.
Yes, Lord.
I've done all I can do
Yes, Lord.
To deal with this situation. Here is the word of God to you today.
Oh, yeah.
God said, tell them, stretch one more time.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, my God. Yes, Lord. That word is for somebody.
Yes, Lord.
Because down inside your belly, you feel defeated. There's a smile on your face, but you feel defeated. But God said, tell them to stretch and trust me one more time.
One more time.
And this time when you stretch,
hey! Thank you, Jesus.
Give a little bit more.
Yes, Lord.
Trust God. I'm telling you about it based on experience.
Yes, Lord.
Stretch a little bit more.
Yes,
love again.
Yes,
stretch a little bit more.
Mm.
Trust somebody again. Stretch just a little bit more. Believe God to do it again. Do you hear me, saints of God?
Yes, Lord.
Stand up on your feet. If you need prayer, I want you to come down now. If you need prayer, I want you to come. If God